Our NASA administrator describes it best. We are the Artemis generation, and we will achieve the most significant series of science missions in over a generation. Simply put, over the course of the next couple of years, the Artemis program will take the first humans back to the moon. And close to the time NASA's Glenn Research Center turns 100 years old, we aim to land on Mars. Our research facilities have been the birthplace and proving grounds for new frontiers of research that won not only wars, but also the space race. Later tonight, you will have the opportunity to hear more about the future of research. But whatever it is, I guarantee it will need a laboratory or a test facility to happen in. This is why planning and building the research and test facilities to support our future goals is a topic I am so passionate about. Fun fact, out of the original 1941 Lewis Field buildings, six major facilities are actively used today. Originally named the Aircraft Engine Research Laboratory, our Cleveland campus was eventually renamed to Lewis Field and expanded to include NASA's Neil Armstrong Test Facility in Sandusky, Ohio. Over the course of the last 82 years, both our country and NASA Glenn have grown side by side. During World War II, we developed aircraft engines and later liquid hydrogen as the rocket fuel that put our country into the space race. At every milestone, NASA Glenn answered our nation's call and our campus grew. We became the agency's leader in aeronautics, communications, space power, and propulsion. And it was about the mid-1970s when the existing campus came to be. Around that time, I was born in a northern city of Mexico called Monterrey. I watched my parents pursue the American dream, from Mexico to Texas, to Puerto Rico, and to Michigan. I had an American dream of my own, but after finishing my graduate studies, the war in Iraq and Afghanistan kicked off. As I watched the TV coverage of the initial invasion, I knew it was now or never. I also had to answer my nation's call. So I enlisted as a U.S. Army engineer officer. During my four combat tours, I got the opportunity to lead some amazing projects, like developing a strategy to rebuild Iraq's Highway 1, key bridges, and roads, and strategic planning initiatives that utilize satellite imagery to conduct infrastructure assessments in combat zones. The parallel that you may see here is that while on separate tracks, both NASA Glenn and I were working towards the same goal: strategic infrastructure planning and execution. And now that fate has brought us together, we are aligned in our plans for the future. Our master plan is called Glenn 100. Using 1941 as a reference point, Glenn 100 outlines the actions we will take before reaching our 100-year mark in 2041. Our master plan has three key goals to get us there. First, we must continue to build modern facilities aligned with the Artemis and Moon to Mars program. Second, we must continue to attract the next generation of star sailors and adventurers. This workforce will take us to places we have never been. These first two initiatives are tied together, and you cannot have one without the other. And finally, we must continue to revitalize some of the infrastructure that supports our research and test facilities. So let's take a look at some of these exciting campus transformation projects we will utilize to achieve our future goals. During the course of the next 2 years at Lewis Field, we will continue to build on past ideas to create Downtown Glenn. Remember the six original buildings I referenced before? One of those is our vintage 1941 administrative building. We are currently relocating the center director's office and all other administrative personnel to the newly built research support building. This move, along with the creation of a modern green space called Wright Park, will become our new cultural center of gravity and complete downtown Glen. Surrounding downtown Glen, we will continue to build modern facilities and group them into distinct neighborhoods with similar capabilities. Here's some great news. Tomorrow, on the west side of campus, we will open the newly built Aerospace Communications Facility, which will be the center of the Aerospace Communications neighborhood. To align with the Artemis to Moon and Moon to Mars program, we want to build two new research facilities, the Electric Power Lab and the Electric Power and Propulsion Facility. These two new buildings will be the centerpiece of the in-space propulsion neighborhood. On the south side, a new Materials for Extreme Environments facility will be in the middle of the Materials and Structures neighborhood. Later tonight, you will get the chance to hear more about the future of materials. At our main campus, we will continue to build and to upgrade and modernize our existing wind tunnel facilities into what will be known the air-breathing propulsion neighborhood and the physical sciences and biomedical neighborhoods. Meanwhile, at NASA's Neil Armstrong Test Facility in Sandusky, our anticipation for the future is high. Multiple companies are partnering with us to pursue commercial spaceflight testing and vehicle certification. To do this, they need access to facilities that only exist here and are not available anywhere else in the world. To attract these companies, we are preparing facilities like the Space Environments Complex, the In-Space Propulsion Facility, and the NASA Electric Aircraft Testbed. This is why we are pursuing new business models to attract outside companies to establish operations on our available land. If we are successful, the economic impact and synergy surrounding Northeast Ohio will be higher than ever before in the history of spaceflight. Glen 100 is vital to our center because it has a direct impact on our second goal, growing the workforce and in turn, boosting the Cleveland economy. Have you ever heard the expression, if you build it, they will come? NASA Glen is no longer the only agency in town pursuing the stars. Our industry partners are also pursuing wow factor facilities. So to attract the best and the brightest minds, our world-class facilities need to be both functional and aesthetically pleasing. We have been working hard on this goal already. And later tonight, you will have the opportunity to meet three bright stars who are already part of the NASA Glen team. I showed you downtown Glen on a map, but nothing does it like a video. So let's take a drive through our main gate and take a peek into the future from a different perspective. Our newly built RSB currently houses our cafeteria, NASA shop, credit union, and conferencing capabilities, and soon will house our center's leadership. Across the street is the future location of Wright Park, meant to be the nucleus of downtown Glen. As you drive south, you can see our plans for future buildings and the Materials for Extreme Environments facility. From a physical campus perspective, there it is, Glen 100. But to get there, we still have one major hurdle. Our third goal is quite frankly the most challenging, revitalizing and maintaining our aging infrastructure. We are constantly coming up with outside-of-the-box ideas to apply technology in areas that seemed out of reach to us only a couple of years ago. Here's a great example. Later tonight, you will have the opportunity to meet Astro the robot dog. He doesn't do fancy receptions every day, so I hope you brought your cameras because he loves to take pictures. He lives in our central air equipment building, where some of the equipment has been operating since World War II. Astro performs work that is hazardous for humans. He conducts robotic inspections by taking pictures and video that give us data to increase equipment reliability while keeping maintenance costs down. I cannot tell you what new challenges and frontiers the future will bring. So the campus we are building today can not only be for the Artemis generation, It's for the kids of future generations with greater aspirations and longer distances to travel in space. When they talk about Glenn 100, I hope they reference us, the pioneers of 2023 who built these facilities. They will be walking in our halls and standing on our shoulders, knowing we had the Glenn 100 plan. Ohio, it's where it all started. But even though this is not where my story started, it's where my future is. I am so excited to be part of the plan that takes aviation and aeronautics into the future and to watch you, the Cleveland community, lead and inspire future generations. I hope you shared my passion tonight about Glenn 100, because in many ways it describes the path I followed from a remote part of the world to Cleveland. Glenn 100 is how we make sure NASA Glenn goes on forever. My story repeats itself, and someday Glenn 200 becomes a reality. Thank you for listening.